Hi everyone, this is Francesco from the IBM Q DevX team, and in this video I will present you our newest learning tool, IBM Q Demo App. So IBM Q Demo App is a Node.js application which allows developers to experience with MQ messaging patterns like point-to-point, publisher-subscriber and request-response. With this application, you can learn MQ using a graphical user interface. So this means that you can drag and drop your own instances of producers, consumers, queues, and observe how messages are exchanged using MQ. In this video, I will show you how you can download and install this application in your local machine so that you can start learning MQ now. Let's jump in the console. So the first thing to do is cloning the project from our GitHub repository, IBM Messages MQ Dev Patterns. We can clone this project using the git clone commands and the name of this repository in our local machine. Once this cloning process is completed, we can see the inside to observe the different folders. The only folder we need for this project is IBM Messaging MQ Cloud Showcase App. This folder consists of backend, frontend, and some YAML file. So the frontend contains the code base for running the graphical user interface, where the user will interact with. Then all these commands from the frontend will communicate with the backend. The backend is kind of the processor. Is responsible for sending all the messaging requests to the queue manager. So the first thing to do is editing the .env file. So this file contains four main properties, but we need to set up only two of them, as well as app password and admin password. The other two, image ECS registry URI and cluster name, are using for configuring the URL and the cluster name if we want to run this application on AWS cloud. So the app password is used for indicating the backend, which is the password used for communicating with the queue manager. So we can set up a password for this. Let's call this app password, and the same for admin password. The main difference here is the admin password is used for specific administrational tasks that the backend required for the queue manager. So since we are running this on our local machine, we don't need to configure the other two properties. So now we can save and we can run the application itself. So since backend, frontend, the queue manager runs on three containers that are launched through the Docker Compose, the first thing to do is build the three images running Docker Compose build. So since I already built this, the process doesn't take long, but it can take up to 1 minute. We can now start our application running Docker Compose app. This command will start the three containers, and once this process is completed, the last message in the console should be Webpack compiled. We can now access the application going on localhost port 3000. If you are running this in a local machine, in my case, I'm running this application on a remote machine on this IP. So we'll go to the IP of the machine, port 3000. With this application, you can explore the different IBM Q messaging patterns, point-to-point, publisher-subscriber, and request-response. So as default, the pre-selected pattern is the point-to-point, but you can easily switch between patterns and environment by clicking this tab on the top. So this is the environment for the publisher-subscriber, and this is for the request-response. So let's start with the point-to-point. So the point-to-point is the easiest messaging pattern we have in MQ, where basically there are three entities, a producer, a consumer, and a queue. So the producer is this application that wants to put some messages in a queue. The queue itself is the entity that stores these messages. There are consumers, there's an application that want to get and consume these messages. So these three entities has been represented with this application using these three visual components. The first component on the top is for representing an instance of a producer. And there is this in the middle for representing a queue, and the last one for representing a new instance of a consumer application. So you can easily creating these instances by dragging and dropping in the workspace these components.
So you can get a new producer and you can add this on the workspace. In this way, you are basically creating a new application which will produce some messages. In the same way, you can drag and drop a consumer and a queue which will be used for messages between these two applications. Here is the basic scenarios. Obviously, the producer and the consumer have to be connected to the queue itself for exchanging messages. So for connecting a producer with a queue, you can join together these blue handles by creating a line, and the same for the consumers. You want to connect these orange handles together. So now that they are connected, you can start putting some messages from a producer and observe how the consumer will use these messages. So by clicking these create bookings, you are putting some messages. So this application has been designed around the ticket reselling scenario. So this means that a producer can be considered as a organization that try to organize an event and is try to generating some tickets that will be available for sales for the users. A message is a ticket, and the consumer are all these applications that users can use to book and buy these tickets. So within each component, there are different fields. For example, for the queue, there are three main informations. One is the current depth, as well as the number of messages or tickets that are currently in the queue. The name of the queue is devqueue.1, which is the default queues. It's one of the default queues. So in Queue Manager, there are three main default queues, which are devqueue1, devqueue2, and devqueue3. And then there is the max depth. So the max depth indicates the number of the maximum number of messages or tickets in this case that can be put in the in a specific queue. This field can be changed going on the IBM web console. So now that the system is connected, we can also add additional tickets by selecting the number of tickets we want to generate. And say we want to generate 15 tickets. So let's put 15. So we can observe the current number of messages is changed here. So we can now consume messages, switching on this this button in the component representing the consumer. And inside we can actually read the content of the message, which in this case, it just says you bought a new ticket and the date time of the transaction. You can add as many consumers as you want, and you can scale up the systems. For example, you can have two consumers here, but at the same time, you can have a new queue with a new producer where we can add 20 messages, and then you can start adding consumers. They will be connected to DevQueue2 and will buy tickets storing in this queue. So before I illustrated how point-to-point can be used to enable communication between a producer and a consumer, and how queues underpin this communication. Let's see now how publisher-subscriber can be used and which are the characteristics of this button. We have a publisher-subscriber messaging when a message is published by a producer to a topic that will be delivered to all the subscribers of that topic. So now let's see the basic concept behind this button. So first of all, a topic is an object with some properties. Messages are published to a topic by a publisher. Each publication is to a single topic only, and subscribers register an interest in or subscribe to a topic. When a publisher publishes a message to a topic, all the subscribers for that topic receive a copy of the message. For a message to be delivered to a subscriber, both the publisher and the subscriber must match the same topic. The subscribers will not receive messages that are produced from the time they made the subscription itself. In PubSub, everything is really around the topics. Trees can include special characters, except for the hash. So the hash is the character that indicates wildcards. In this video, I want to go through this concept, but you can find additional information in the link in the description. So talking about the scenario, let's imagine that the organizers, in addition to generate some tickets, they also want to send email marketing to all the customers. There are two types of customers. Customers that have a VIPs ticket and customers that have a classic ticket. So obviously the organizers cannot send all this amount of emails at the same time, one by one. The publisher subscriber messaging pattern solve these problems because allow these customers with a classic ticket to be subscribed to a classic topic, and allow customer with a VIP ticket to be subscribed to a VIP topic. In this way, we can create two publishes, one that we publish to the classic topic and one that we publish to the VIP topic. So the publication, or better, the message that will be published will be the email itself. The publisher that will publish to the classic topic will enable all the customers with a classic ticket to receive that email. In the same way, the publisher that will publish to the VIP topic will enable all these customers with the VIP subscription to receive the email itself. So let's see now how this scenario can be designed with our application. So the first thing to do is to create these two topics, as well as tickets classic and ticket VIP. So to do so, the only thing we need to do is dragging and dropping this visual component that represents the topic. So let's get two of these components. Now we need to set the topic string as well as the tree of these topics. We need just to write in this available space the name of the topic string. So let's say tickets classic for the classic topic and tickets VIP for the VIP topic. We can now connect our subscribers as well as our customers. So to do so, we need to get the components that represent the subscribers, so which are basically these components at the bottom. So let's say we have two customer applications for with a classic ticket and two customer application with a VIP ticket. So let's drag and drop these four instances of application. So we said two for the classic ticket and two for the VIP ticket. To enable customers with a classic ticket to receive the specific email, we need to register their interest in the respective topic, as well as we need to create a subscription to tickets classic. In this application, create subscription is really straightforward. To subscribe this customer to a classic topic, we simply need to create a line that join these orange handles two together. So as you can see in the bottom right, there is a confirmation of your subscription. So in the same way, to enable customers with a VIP ticket to receive VIP emails, we need to subscribe them to tickets VIP topic. So we do the same for these two subscribers as well. So once all the subscribers have a subscription to the right topic, we are now ready to publish these emails. For sending an email to all our customer application with a classic ticket, we need to perform a publication to the tickets classic topic. So to do so, we need to add a publish application that will publish some messages to that topic. So let's drag and drop the visual component that we need for representing the publish application. So once we add the publisher to the workspace, we need to connect this publisher to the specific topic its messages will be published to. So to do so, we need to join together these blue handles with a line. So we are now ready for sending this email to the classic customer application. The only last thing to do is add our content of the email we want to send. So let's say the object is email for customers one, the content for our classic customers. So now that this email has been designed, we need to click Send Notification to create the publication to the specific topic. So once this message has been published, we can see that all the subscribers subscribed to the Tickets Classic received a copy of the message we sent. The exact same process applies for sending VIP emails to the customers with a VIP ticket, but with the main difference that the publisher will publish these messages to the Tickets VIP topic instead of Tickets Classic. So let's move on to our last pattern, request response. So request response is a conversational messaging pattern where the application that sends a message requires a response from the receiving application. The request response messaging pattern is often built on top of the point-to-point messaging pattern, and can be a synchronous operation. The sending application sets a reply to destination and the correlation ID so that the response message can be routed and matched to the originating request message by the requesting application. This pattern has been already designed for you. So on the left-hand side, we have our request components. Then in the middle, there is the queue. In this case, is devqueue.3. And on the right-hand side, there is the responder component. So to experience with this pattern, the first thing to do is create a request. So to do so, you can click on the Submit Request button located at the bottom of the request component. So by clicking this button, as you can see, a new queue has been generated. This happens only when the request message is sent successfully to devqueue.3, and this temporary queue is the queue where the requesting application will expect the response application to reply, and is often referred to as a reply to queue. It is responsibility of the requesting application to share the reply to queue information with the response application. The response component will consume a new message from the requester when the switch on the right hand side, as well as this switch, is clicked. The message sent from the requester contains two values, as I said, the payload itself and the property that contain the reply queue name. The reply to queue name is a temporary queue. In our example, is app.reply6414, etc. And after a new request message is received, you can insert your response into this text box. And we can send this message back to the requester by clicking the reply button. As you can see, the temporary queue get the message and the requester now receive back the response that can be that appears in the text below this button. Also, after the reply message is received back to the requester, the reply to queue, which is basically temporary queue, is deleted because the conversational is completed. So just to recap, in this video, I introduce you with this new powerful tool to experience with IBM queue and its pattern using graphical components. The code base for this tutorial is open source and can be found on our GitHub repository at www.ibm.biz/mq-patterns, and we really would love your feedback and contributions. There is also a tutorial showing how to deploy this application on AWS cloud, which link is www.ibm.biz/mq-showcase-app. I would just say thanks a lot for listening and have a lovely day.